Hello, lovely people, welcome to Everything Crochet and More. I'm your host Hitel Patel, and this is the video tutorial for crochet my little frog motif Costa. Now this is what the Costa looks like, and this Costa has some 3D flowers. So for this Costa we've used four my little frog motifs, and we've joined these motifs, and then there are three rounds of this beautiful edging, and I've made three rounds of for my edging, and this edging has cross stitch. It gives a nice texture to our costa. This square costa measures about 5 inches in length and weighs about 13 grams. So for this coaster, using 2.5 mm crochet hook and size 10 cotton thread, we'll be needing 13 grams of size 10 cotton. This coaster will surely bring a refreshing aesthetic to your table setting this summer season. So the link for the video tutorial of my little flower motif and how to join these beautiful motif is given in the description box below, and you can also find the link in the playlist of this video tutorial. So let's begin with our costa. So to make my little flower costa, we'll be needing four my little flower motifs, and we'll be joining these motifs. So the link of the joining video tutorials is in the description box below, or you can find it in the playlist of this costa as well. So here we've made this motif using a 10 cotton thread and a 2.5 mm crochet hook. So we'll be joining these motifs, and after joining these, I'll be making the edging of the costa using a different colored size 10 crochet thread. So I'll be using a contrasting colored thread, as you all can see here. If you all want, you all can make it in the same colored thread, or you all can use a contrasting thread. It's entirely up to you. So without any further ado, let's start making this costa. So for that, first we'll be joining these motifs, and I'll be doing this off camera. Now let's begin with the edging. So we'll begin with a slip knot, like so. Now slip knot done. Select a vertice. So I'll be selecting this vertice. And then put your hook through the third chain stitch of this chain 5 loop. So start counting 1, 2, and 3. So put your hook through that third chain stitch and make a slip stitch, like so. Slip stitch done, chain 1, and we'll be making 3 single crochet in this same third chain stitch. So put your hook through the same stitch and 1 single crochet, 2 single crochet, and 3 single crochet. 3 single crochet is done. Now here, in the remaining part of this chain 5 loop here, we'll be making a single crochet. So put your hook through that remaining part of the loop and make a single crochet. Now that done, followed by a single crochet on the next double crochet stitch, like so. Followed by 4 single crochets in the next chain 5 loop. So put your hook under that chain 5 loop and 1, 2, 3, and 4. 4 single crochets done, followed by a single crochet in the next single crochet stitch. So put your hook in that single crochet stitch and a single crochet, followed by 4 single crochets in the next chain 5 loop. So 1, 2, 3, and 4. 4 single crochets done, followed by 1 single crochet on the next double crochet stitch. So put your hook in that stitch and a single crochet. Then a single crochet in the first part of this chain 5 loop here. So put your hook under this loop and a single crochet. That done, then a single crochet in this joining single crochet stitch. So put your hook in that single crochet stitch and a single crochet. That done, then you'll be making a single crochet this remaining part of this 5 chain loop. So put your hook under that loop and a single crochet. Now that done, we'll be making a single crochet in the next double crochet stitch. So put your hook in that stitch and a single crochet. Now that done, followed by 4 single crochets in the next chain 5 loop. So put your hook in that loop and 1, 2, 3 and 4. 4 single crochets done. Then a single crochet in the next single crochet stitch like so. That done, followed by again 4 single crochet in the next chain 5 loop. So 1, 2, 3 and 4. 4 single crochets done, followed by 1 single crochet on the next double crochet stitch like so. Now we'll be making 1 single crochet in the next chain 5 loop. So put your hook under that chain 5 loop and a single crochet. So we've reached the second vertex of this first side of our square coaster. So what we'll be doing is here, again, after making a single crochet, we'll be making 3 single crochets in the third chain stitch of this chain 5 loop. So 1, 2 and put your hook in the third chain stitch and make 3 single crochets. So 1, 2 and 3. Now that done, now after making this 3 single crochet loop, we'll be repeating everything that we've done after making the first 3 single crochet stitches in the beginning. So we'll be repeating everything that we've done. 1 single crochet in the remaining part of this chain 5 loop, followed by a single crochet on the next double crochet stitch, followed by 4 single crochets in the next chain 5 loop, followed by a single crochet on a single crochet. So we'll be repeating everything that we have done on this side of the square coaster after this 3 single crochet loop. So what we'll be doing here is, after we've made this 3 single crochet loop, we'll be making a single crochet in the remaining part of this chain 5 loop here. Then we'll be making a single crochet on the next double crochet stitch, followed by 4 single crochets in the next chain 5 loop, followed by a single crochet on the next single crochet stitch, followed by 4 single crochets in the next 5 chain loop, and followed by a single crochet in the remaining part of this next chain 5 loop, followed by a single crochet on this single connecting single crochet stitch, followed by a single crochet in the remaining part of this chain 5 loop here, followed by a single crochet on the next double crochet stitch, followed by 4 double crochets in the next chain 5 loop, followed by a single crochet on the next single crochet stitch, followed by 4 single crochets in the next chain 5 loop, followed by a single crochet on the next double crochet stitch, followed by a single crochet in the next chain 5 loop here. Now we have reached the third vertex. What we'll be doing here as well is, after making a single crochet in the loop of this chain 5, we'll be making 3 single crochets in the third chain stitch, and we'll be repeating everything again on the other side as well. So we'll be repeating this pattern of single crochets here 3 more times to finish with the first round of the edging of our coaster. So let's finish making the next 3 sides of this coaster as well. So in round 1, we must have 120 single crochets. So let's finish making the next remaining single crochets. Now the last single crochet of our first round done, we'll finish our first round with a slip stitch in the first single crochet stitch. So put your hook through that stitch and pull thread through like so to make a slip stitch. Now with this, we finish with our round 1, and this is what our coaster looks like at the moment.
Now, round 2 is nothing but single crochets all around except for 3 single crochets on second single crochet stitch. Of every 3 single crochets on each of these vertices, let's begin. Here we'll begin with the first 3 single crochet group. So chain 1 and a single crochet in the first single crochet stitch, like followed by 3 single crochet in the next single crochet stitch, that is the second single crochet of this 3 single crochet group. So put your hook in that second single crochet stitch and 1 single crochet, 2 single crochet and 3 single crochet. So 3 single crochet is done, a single crochet in the next single crochet stitch, again a single crochet in the next and a single crochet in the next, again a single crochet in the next, and so on. We'll be making 1 single crochet in each and every single crochet stitch till we reach the next 3 single crochet group. There we'll be making 1 single crochet in the first single crochet stitch, followed by 3 single crochet in the second single crochet stitch, then again 1 single crochet in the next, that is the third single crochet stitch. So we'll be repeating this all around till we finish making single crochets in each and every single crochet stitch of the previous round. So let's finish making our single crochets. So in round 2 we will have 128 single crochets in total. There'll be an increase in 8 single crochets from round 1. So let's finish making the rest of the single crochet stitches of our round 2. Please do count, it should have 128 single crochet stitches in total in round 2. So each side will have 32 single crochets. So the last single crochet of round 2 done. Now let's finish our round 2 with a slip stitch in the first single crochet stitch. So put your hook in the first single crochet stitch and pull thread through like so to make a slip stitch. Now with this, we finish with our round 2 of our edging. Now we'll begin with our round 3. Now round 3 is made up of 4 double crochet cross stitches. So for that, we'll begin with chain 3, 1, 2 and 3. Chain 3 done. Now we'll skip the next, single crochet stitch and we'll double crochet in the next single crochet stitch. So put your hook in that single crochet stitch like so and a double crochet, followed by a double crochet in the next single crochet stitch. So put your hook in that single crochet stitch and a double crochet. Now that done, now we'll be making chain 1. Now chain 1 done, again yarn over once, and now what we'll be doing is we'll be making a double crochet in the single crochet that we've skipped. So put your hook through that single crochet, pull thread from behind like so, and a double crochet, again yarn over once, and put your hook in the single crochet stitch in which we've made this chain 3 for height like so. So put your hook through that single crochet stitch and pull thread from behind like so, and a double crochet. Now with this, we finish making, is actually a bit different than the rest of the 4 double crochet cross stitches that we'll be making, as it has a one chain space between the 2 double crochet stitches. Now this cross stitch that we've made is actually at the vertice of this side, so that is why, to give it a subtle sharp edge, we've made chain 1 between the 2 double crochet stitches. But in the next 4 double cross stitches, there will be no chain 1 stitch between the 2 double crochet stitches. So keeping that in mind, let's proceed with our round 3. So yarn over once. Now we'll skip the next 2 single crochet stitch. So skip the first, the second, and we'll double crochet in the next single crochet stitch like so. Again, we'll double crochet in the next single crochet stitch like so. Now that done, now yarn over once and we'll double crochet in the single crochet stitch nearest to this double crochet group. So the nearest single crochet stitch is this one. So put your hook through that single crochet stitch and a double crochet. Now that done, again yarn over once and we'll make a double crochet in the remaining single crochet stitch. So put your hook in that single crochet stitch and make a double crochet. Now that done, now in this side in total we'll be making 7 such 4 double crochet cross stitches. So 1 done, 6 more to go. I'll be showing this y'all one more time, and the next 5 I'll be doing off camera. So again, yarn over once, skip next 2 single crochet stitches. So 1 and 2, and a double crochet in the third single crochet stitch like so. 1 and 2. Then again yarn over once and a double crochet in the next single crochet stitch like so. Now 2 single crochet group done here. Now we'll be making a double crochet in the single crochet stitch nearest to this double crochet group. So yarn over once, put your hook in that single crochet stitch that is nearest to this group and a double crochet. Again yarn over once and we'll be making a double crochet in the remaining single crochet stitch. So put your hook through that single crochet stitch, pull thread through that stitch like so, and double crochet. So 2 done. Let's finish making the next 5 cross stitches of this side. Now the 7th cross stitch done. Now we'll be making the 8th cross stitch, that will be the vortice stitch. The same way we've made the first cross stitch here, we'll be making the 8th cross stitch at this edge as well. So for that, yarn over once. So we'll skip the next 2 single crochet stitches, 1 and 2, and we'll double crochet in the third single crochet stitch like so. Again yarn over once and we'll double crochet in the next single crochet stitch followed by chain 1. The same thing that we've done in the first cross stitch here. So chain 1 done, yarn over once and put your hook in the nearest skipped single crochet stitch followed by again yarn over once and put your hook through the remaining single crochet stitch and a double crochet. Now that done, now we have 2 vertices to our square here. Now after we've made this, we'll be doing exactly what we've done after making the first vertice cross stitch here. We'll be making 7 cross stitches along this side of our square. After making 7 cross stitches, again we'll reach the edge here, we'll reach the next vertice, and there as well we'll be doing the same thing that we've done at these 2 vertices. So like so, we'll be repeating this process 3 more times to finish the next 3 sides like this square coaster. So let's finish making the next 3 sides of this square coaster. Now the last cross stitch done. Now we'll slip stitch in the first double crochet stitch of our round 3 like so. to finish with our round. Now with this, we finish with our round 3 and our costa. We'll weave in the ends. Now here we have 4 cross stitches, 1 cross stitch with 1 chain between them on every vertice, and between these 4 vertices on each side we must have 7 normal cross stitches. So here, as you can see, 3 and 4, 7, and 3 and 4, 7, and 3 and 4, 7, and between these two is 3 and 4, 7. With this, we finish with our My Little Flower Costa. If you like what you see, then hit that thumbs up. If you all have any questions or suggestions, please leave them in the comment section below. And please do subscribe to our channel and press that bell icon for instant notification on our latest video tutorials. And I'll see you all in the next video tutorial. Until then, take care, bye-bye, and happy crocheting.